place this is. Hi, it's E.T. here. I'm hiking here in Barranco Del Infierno, which translates as Hell's Ravine or Hell's Canyon. Quite a name, huh? I'm gonna film my hike from starting point to the end of this trail. So this is going to be quite a long video. But you know, here it is. In the end of the trail, there should be some kind of a waterfall. So I'm gonna film the whole trail to that point. And obviously, I'm gonna take some breaks, drinking breaks. I'm gonna take some photographs, etc. And I will cut those parts off from this video. But we will see what kind of a video this is going to be and what kind of image quality I can get with this camera. If you are going to come here in the future and want to check what kind of terrain this is, or you would like to come here but are unable to do so, so here's the video. You can watch and see what kind of place this is. I'm filming this with my Canon 750D camera, and I'm handheld in this, so the image can be a little bit shaky. Like I mentioned already, this hike is called, or this place is called, Barranco del Infierno, and this is located in Tenerife Island, which belongs to Spain. If you're planning to do some kind of a hiking trip, I can recommend this place, because from this island you can find a lot of different kind of places where you can hike. You got these ravines, you got the pine forests, you have the volcano area, which is a completely different kind of place. You know, nothing grows there basically. Starts from 2 kilometers, and Mount Tate is about 3.8 kilometers, I think. You got almost kind of rainforests in a northern part of this island. You got quite a lot of different kind of places in here, and weather is quite nice usually. In the summertime, it's quite hot, but other part of the year is quite nice. They say that Tenerife is an island of eternal spring, so not too cold, not too hot, usually. This hike starts from a little town of Arehe, located in the southern part of this island, or maybe southwest, kind of there. I'm not gonna talk much during this video, just a little bit here in the start, and after that I will set up and you can enjoy the hike. I think I'm gonna call this video Hiking Barranco del Infierno to get the book, and the name comes from the thing that happened just before the hike. Okay, first of all, this is a closed trail, so you have to pay entrance fee to enter here. Currently, the fee was 8 euros per person. Seems that this trail is open only a few hours per day, if it's open at all. Today it opened about 10:30, and there was already people waiting before me, and they had been here almost 1 hour. But as the trail was closed, it was impossible for them to enter the trail. Like I mentioned, the trail isn't open all the time, only a small part of the day, and depending from the conditions, they might not open it at all. So there is a chance that when you come here, you find that the trail will be closed because of the conditions. In that case, you can't enter the trail legally. So when you are at the starting point of this trail, you pay the entrance fee, and then they give you this piece of paper where you have to put your name and personal details, and read the whole paper and then sign it. in the paper there is all kinds of warnings and things to remember when doing this hike. After you have read it and signed it to guide, we give you a helmet. Wearing your helmet is mandatory here, so you can't enter the trail without wearing that helmet. And he will give you short 5-minute kind of guidance about the trail. After I had paid the fee and signed the paper and received my helmet, I was waiting here for the presentation with the older couple. Then guide arrived, he explained some stuff, and then the lady of the couple said to the guide that I read this book about this ravine. And just after she had said that, the guide said, forget the book, you know, so apparently the book is not good. But that was a really good point, what the guide said, that forget the book. You can learn something from the books, but you can't learn everything. And if the book is 15, 20 years old, the information may be outdated. The trail have certainly changed after that, and so on. And the guy who is working here daily knows these conditions best and knows the trail exactly what it's going to be today. So it's wise to listen to the guy. Likely that most of the hikers who are doing this trail, including me, do not understand how dangerous this hike really is. And because of that, it's good to have updated information from the guide before you do the hike. Like I mentioned, if the conditions are not good enough, they do not open this trail at all. So if it's raining, or I guess if it's quite windy up there, they do not open this trail. Because there is quite a big risk of rock slides and dropping rocks. So up there, there can be small animals, you know, there can be people hiking, whatever, and one small displaced rock may cause a rock slide. Because this trail is quite dangerous, it was actually closed for many years, and it was illegal to enter here. I think that it was closed about 5 years at least. And it was closed because there had been injuries, and even someone had died in this trail. And after that, they decided here that it's too risky for tourists to hike, so they closed it completely. While this was closed, they tried to remove some risks and improve the trail a little bit. And they were able to open this about a couple of years ago, I think. But risks always remain, and a good, or should I say, bad example was the fact that there was almost exactly 6 months ago rock slide, and one people died and two were injured. So it's still not safest place, but what is? But this hike is definitely worth doing. It's an unbelievable place. The trail seems to be in quite good condition all the way. So basically you don't need hiking boots to do this, but I recommend that you have some kind of better shoes. I don't know, you'd say require them, but it's a good thing to have something more than just flip-flops. Besides better shoes, what else you would need to do this hike? I recommend that you bring some kind of backpack. You can add back your camera, your food, your water, etc. to your backpack, and with that it's easy to hike. Depending from the conditions, I think that it's good to bring at least 1.5 liters of fluids, water, etc. That should get you through this trail. Besides of backpack and camera and food and drinks, I recommend that you bring, obviously, some kind of sunblocker, protect you from the sun. But you should also bring waterproof jacket with you. You might not needing it, but the conditions can change quite fast, because in the last part of the hike you're deep in the ravine, and there can be clouds above you which bring a mist or some small rain. And although the starting point is sunny and warm, the end point is much colder. So it's a good option to have waterproof jacket with you. Obviously you can bring your phone, etc. But since that there are no reception, at least not in the deepest part, so you can't call from here. If you're planning to do this hike, I certainly can recommend this to you. This is one of those must-see places. But I think that's enough talk at the moment. I'm gonna shut up and let you enjoy the hike. See you on the trail.
Hello. Hello.
Hello. Thank you.
Buenos días.
Buenos días.